Hi, my name is Killer Boss Benki, and here at Mount Elizabeth, I give the best care to my patients, I think.
Bro, what? Can you come sign this death certificate?
Okay, so do you like working for Dr. Rodrigo?
He's alright. He tried to stab me once, but he's a good boss, I think.
Oh god.
Oh god.
I think I'm stone. Oh, my brother, see.
He's the best boss I've ever had.
Oh, what's your name? I'm pretty stoned. I took a lot of coke yesterday.
So, okay.
Do you like to cuddle?
What's your opinion on Dr. Rodrigo's approach to treatment?
Dr. Rodrigo? I don't think he's a real doctor. Yeah. I think he's trying to kill me. No, I don't.
Whatever. I've always been lonely my whole life.
Oh. I don't give a shit. So, tell me, what kind of problems do you have? Psychological, infectious disease, the type of plastic surgery, I don't know, what doctor am I?
Okay. So actually, all of my problems. Here's my list. Botched fish top, number one. Second, Ebola. I also have fever, cold, back pain, lower back pain. I can't breathe often.
Do not laugh. Session is in progress.
I accidentally laugh sometimes.
Last week I shot a toddler on Jimmy Fallon. It's really fun. So the cops chased after me. I end up living in a tow truck of a guy named Pedro, and he kicked me up. I farted on him. Yeah, and then now I'm just at the hospital now doing my shit. Hey, actually, why aren't you responding to my story? People who normally aren't stoned out, which are quite little, do respond to my story. Let me check. Maybe you fell unconscious. Let me take my stethoscope and check. Oh my god! He's alive. Well, I'm off to do my normal shit at the hospital. Oh, there's Nurse Joy, normally. Nurse Joy! Catch!
Oh, God.
I'm off to do my hospital shot.
So, he's dead. We called his family, like, an hour ago. He's dead. He flatlined. We called you, but you were...
Flatline. What does that mean? Is he literally flatline?
He's dead.
So, director, as you can tell, I'm British. Also, I want to ask you about one of our patients we had at the hospital, Vladimir Smith, the inventor of chemistry.
Oh, that's Killer Boss Binky's patient. I trust him dearly with any patient he has. He has an amazing track record at this hospital, and I really believe in him as a doctor. Come in.
He's gone.
What?
Man, what are we gonna do? I'm scared.
I don't know, I have honestly no idea, and I really don't care.
We if the media finds out about this, we're really screwed. So, what do we do?
Oh no, the director's here.
What happened here?
Crap.
Okay, look,
why is another patient gone?
I'm just a receptionist, I didn't have anything to do with this.
Director, come on, please. He's just, you don't think of him as a big boss. Come on, he's just one of maybe 5,000 patients who've died here at Mount Elizabeth.
Look,
please,
my credibility
here.
Is on
we
the line
the
here.
Best service.
How did he die?
What do you give him?
Come on, you know what? You can trust me. I give the best kind of medication, you know?
What medication did you give him?
Give him Panadol. The best cure for Ebola, back pain, low back pain.
Panadol?
Yeah.
Please, wait, not more than 100 milligrams, right?
But they said 500,000.
Oh,
no, where'd you get so much Panadol?
Okay, we can't have another death like this on our record. The family's gonna sue us, but my credibility's gone. Our hospital.
Oh my, just fire me, okay? I've been fired 9 times
on
the same job.
You know what? You're gonna clean this up yourself.
No, I'm not touching that dead body. I'm not.
I got other things to attend to. You guys deal with this stuff here.
I just get out of this room, learn your fat ass playing Clash Royale.
So. There's no reason to.
Shut up, Pamela. Get out. I like locking pieces of shit face. I'm not touching that body. Pamela, clean it up.
Or what, sir?
Or else I'll fire you.
So the director isn't giving me much information on the whereabouts of Vladimir. Could you possibly help?
Yeah, he went on vacation. He's perfectly cured. He's in perfect health. He went on vacation. He went to ski in Canada.
No, I'll get that.
No. You
so
take the legs.
Fucking fat.
You take the legs. At least he's quite small. So come on, we gotta find a place to hide it.
Oh my god, he's fat.
Yeah, move it there, move it there.
Where do we find it?
Move it,
Do you not just scream at him?
We'll put him under, we'll put him somewhere. Nobody could possibly find it.
Damn it, Pamela.
How about here?
Under the desk?
Under the desk.
Are you sure he can fit his fat ass body under there?
Yeah, of course.
Sorry, you're the nurse. I mean, whatever your job is, I don't really give a shit anymore.
You said him,
yeah. So, what do we do now?
Look at that, my iron golem is beating
you. No, why would you put an inferno dragon in a contract?
Oh, look at that.
You're such a dumpy shit, Pamela.
I'm clashing
your
royale.
God, I don't know why I hired you.
Royale with cheese.
Such a piece of shit. Oh my god.
Look at that, you're...
Now I'm gonna lose like 9 trophies all because of you. Fucking suck, Pamela.
No, you aren't very good at Clash Royale.
I'm in Legendary Arena.
Arena
13, you're in Goblin Stadium, Arena
1. yo, hold up.
What? I mean, he's laughing at
me. Wait. Who's filming this?
Ha ha ha. Time for the reveal.
No!
Could you hold the camera for a moment?
What?
Turn it back to me.
What? Yeah, that's right!
Oh,
it's him! The entire
god,
time!
I didn't realize that at all!
It's him!
Yeah.
Turns out, I was an undercover cop the entire
time. Oh my
time.
God, and he's
oh
a yellow
god.
Belt.
I knew it!
I am a yellow belt.
This can't be real! No, it can't be real! Can't be real! I can't believe this. Can't believe you're a yellow belt.
What's up playing Clash Royale?
After all those years of practicing karate, can't believe you're a yellow belt. Take this,